We've been associated with the University of Iowa for almost two decades with the Tropical Rainfall Measuring Mission. It was a satellite that launched in 1997. It was supposed to be a three-year mission. It's still there now, so it's a really wonderful mission. And then we're on to the follow-on, which is the Global Precipitation Measurement Mission. And we're still working with Dr. Vitek Krajewski at the University of Iowa.
NASA is planning a satellite in a mission called Global Precipitation Measurement. It is an international mission involving actually several satellites that will be flying in space around, the Earth, and together providing data to map precipitation worldwide.
We brought our flagship radar, which is called NPOL. It's a state-of-the-art weather radar, which will allow us to do high-quality rain mapping, precipitation. The main goal here is to try to provide a more physical description of what we see in the atmosphere. So when the satellite comes across and they're trying to use physical algorithms from space, that we can kind of validate in a physical means rather than what's been done in the past, which is a more kind of statistical comparing my measurement versus their measurement. Now we're actually looking at the physics of precipitation to help them build their algorithms in a more robust way.
With the creation of the Iowa Flood Center following the flood of 2008, we have developed a very good research infrastructure, here in eastern Iowa. So the appealing, factors, for them was that we were in a position to provide a very good support and contribute our own observational assets. But we also have floods here in Iowa. And the way this is relevant is because this GPM mission is not to serve, just rainfall data collection for its own, purposes, but to help with applications, different water resources applications. And many of those have to do with the prediction of rainfall-induced natural hazards. So, of course, floods, come to mind right away. But floods and landslides, those are the key ones. And again, with the data from the mission, they will be able to do this worldwide.
So what we're actually doing is we're trying to simulate what this GPM satellite is going to see, because it's orbiting the Earth, and so it's looking down on Earth from the top of the atmosphere all the way down to the surface of the Earth. And so with the weather radar, we're measuring from above the cloud, above the raining cloud, all the way as close to the ground as we can with the radar. So that will be used to simulate what the satellite's seeing within the cloud. But then now actually at the ground, and what's occurring at the ground is where these rain gauge and the astrometers come in. So they will give us ground truth of what's occurring. So we take this data, this rain gauge and astrometer data set, and combine it with this radar data set from NPOL and also the National Weather Service radars, and we reconstruct what the satellite would actually see. So then we can determine with a high degree of accuracy how much rainfall this satellite would see, giving these certain conditions that have been observed. So the purpose of doing that, and one of the purposes of this studies, is actually to improve the hydrologic prediction, meaning improve the way that we measure rainfall more. We want to measure it more accurately over much larger areas of the globe that don't have, say, rain gauges and gastrometers. And also not only the measurement technique, but also the techniques that are used to forecast where that water, when it falls on the ground, where it's going to go, and then where it's actually going to flood. And so it'll help better warn the citizens who are maybe in the area of the flood-prone areas.